Extraordinary benefit concert features poet supreme master Ching Hai, Beach Boys family and friends, award-winning composers and conductors Bill Conti, Fred Carlin, Maria Newman, George Thatcher, and Peter Boyer. Also featuring the Irish band from Titanic, Gaelic Storm, Mel Kubik, Nicole Campbell, Stevie Mercer, and Marie Ketchum, Kerry Walsh, and Jerome Smith, with the Pasadena Boys Choir and accompanied by one of Los Angeles' finest 60-piece orchestras. This evening will be hosted by film legend Debbie Reynolds and esteemed board member of the Starlight Children's Foundation, John Mochita. One World of Peace Through Music is proudly produced by Stephen Cooper and Dr. Larry Tibb and presented by the Supreme Master Ching Hai International Association. Tonight's proceeds will be contributed to Starlight Children's Foundation and St. Jude's Children Research Hospital.
Poet Supreme Master Ching Hai, esteemed guests, and ladies and gentlemen, welcome to One World of Peace Through Music. And thank you for your presence on this wonderful evening at the prestigious Shrine Auditorium. Music has existed in all people since the beginning of time, and is one of the formative aspects that have allowed us to define ourselves and our cultures over the centuries. Music speaks to all people, regardless of their native tongue, and carries an immense power to unite us. It is fitting this evening, therefore, that the universal language of music is the golden thread that brings us together for a night celebrating peace and joy. With a diverse showcase of accomplished talents, each expressing his or her own interpretation of the theme, One World of Peace Through Music, it's a pleasure to offer the audience tonight such a high caliber of performances which will grace the stage. Earlier on, many of you were able to view an exhibition of the beautiful artistic creations of the poet, Supreme Master Ching Hai. Later on tonight, you will also hear and experience many moving and inspirational selections of her poetry set to music by distinguished and award-winning composers. To help introduce our highly accomplished artists and tonight's program, our first host is a gentleman who is famous for his ability to out-talk anyone at any party. He is listed in the Guinness Book of World Records for speaking 586 words in 1 minute. A frequent celebrity on television and at special events, our host is also a dedicated humanitarian through and through. It is my honor to introduce to you Mr. John Mochita.
Well, good evening, everybody. You know, I'm really surprised to see so many faces here. It was really warm all this week, and everybody was out there probably getting sun and doing all that kind of stuff, and then it got cold, and I thought everyone was going to think, oh, it's too cold to go out tonight. I don't want to go out tonight. Why don't we just stay home and we'll watch reruns of Cupid or whatever else is on, happens to be on the TV on Saturday night, and I didn't really think anyone was going to be here, but you're all here, so welcome! We are about to experience a unique entertainment entitled One World of Peace Through Music. Through the harmony in all music, we are here tonight to enjoy an evening of peace and creativity. We begin with a music and culture that has had a remarkable influence on the world as we know it today. 2,500 years ago today, there existed a people known as the Celts. Music was central to their lives, and the singers of this era traveled the countryside rather like a musical newspaper. And through these musicians, the people stayed united. Now, music has that quality, the ability to unite. Well, with that in mind, I am very happy to introduce a truly fine group of talented musicians. I'm sure most of you will recognize their wonderful music from the soundtrack of the motion picture Titanic. In the words of Leonardo DiCaprio in the hit movie, "Wanna go to a real party?" Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the musical spirit of Gaelic Storm.
Thanks very much. Thank you very much indeed. Ladies and gentlemen, how about another round of applause for Supreme Master Ching Hai? Thank you so much for having us.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to sing a song. It's a children's song from the north of Ireland, a place called Belfast. So it's called "I'll Tell Me Ma."
We'd like to dedicate this song to Supreme Master Ching Hai for all the good that she's doing for the children through the Starlight Foundation with this event tonight. So, on that note, I'll tell me ma.
by, and she's as nice as apple pie, and she'll get her own lad by and by. When she gets a lad of her own, she won't tell a man when she comes home. Let them all come best they will, it's Patrick Murphy.
Here we go.
Guys are terrific. Boy, weren't they great? You know, it's an honor to be here this evening, and it's also an honor to introduce my very talented co-host. She's the legendary star of stage, screen, and television. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Debbie Reynolds. Ladies and gentlemen, at the early age of...
47.
Debbie was discovered by both Warner Brothers and MGM when she was only...
47.
Her vivacious personality and bubbling good looks soon landed her lead roles in motion picture classics, Singing in the Rain, How the West Was Won, Unsinkable Molly Brown. Debbie has made over 35 motion pictures.
47.
Well, Debbie, you look sensational. You know, a little bird told me backstage that tonight just happens to be your birthday. So, sure, a big round of applause. How old are you?
47.
Yeah. Well, that works for me.
Yeah, sure.
I'll take that one any day.
Okay.
Well, good evening, John. And I'm absolutely delighted to be here. Truly beautiful.
Well, it is delightful to meet you. You know, you have made a film that also captured the Titanic, like our last act there, the Unsinkable Molly Brown.
Yes. Yeah.
That was such a great movie. And as good as Kathy Bates was in Titanic, I just kept waiting for her to just break into song, and it just wasn't the same for me. But I went out, I rented the movie, and there were so many highlights for me. Did you have a favorite line from that movie?
Well, yes, I said, I rang for ice, but this is ridiculous. A large Titanic. Well, this is going to be a very spectacular evening, and I'm especially pleased for its theme, unity. One world of peace through music. Some of my most joyous memories are linked to special songs and to the passion with which music is performed. Since all peoples communicate with music, wouldn't it be nice if music were the thread to help weave world peace?
Well, I think that's certainly true. And with that in mind, we would like to present this beautiful composition composed by Ms. Maria Newman and featuring the enchanting lyrics of poet Master Ching Hai. Master Ching Hai, yes? Master Ching Hai has written many beautiful love poems, and this one is entitled The Prince. Now, Ms. Newman was inspired by the poetry and created this beautiful synergy of opera, orchestra, and poetry. And tonight, the piece will be conducted by Mr. George Thatcher with vocals by Anne Marie Ketchum.
Ladies and gentlemen, The Prince.
Really know
Together, fly from the road, the Lord has planned, and though weeping, we'll all
That was beautiful. That was so lovely. Thank you, thank you. This next piece is conducted by the young and energetic maestro of the modern day orchestra, Mr. Peter Boyer, an award-winning composer and conductor. Mr. Boyer will be conducting his own adaptation of Master Ching Hai's poetic lyrics, Love Melody 4. The beautiful lyrics of this poem reflect the intensity of love and longing when parted from one's significant other. The recording motif of How Many Miles draws us to the passionate yearning to be reunited with one's true love. And I would like to share one of the verses with you. How many miles to West Side? How many miles to paradise? How many miles to your heart? How many miles to mine? Ladies and gentlemen, here is Mr. Peter Boyer with Miss Carrie Walsh and our wonderful orchestra with Love Melody 4.
You.
Thank you, Mr. Peter Boyer, Ms. Kerry Walsh, and members of tonight's wonderful orchestra.
They are fabulous.
Aren't they great?
They are great. Love Melody 4 is truly such a beautiful piece. And it is the second composition this evening inspired by the lyrics of poet Supreme Master Ching Hai. Yes. Mr. Fred Carlin is one of the finest film music composers in our business. And I'm sure that you all remember his Academy Award-winning song, For All We Know, recorded by the Carpenters and my very good friend Liza Minnelli. He has an incredible list of credits. In fact, it is so long that it would take all night to just...
Not necessarily. Not necessarily. Let's see. What has this guy done before? Because I mean, we all know about, you know, the one song that you mentioned. Has he done anything else? Let's see. Up the Down Staircase, Your Minor Hours, The Stalking Moon, The Sterile Cuckoo, Lovers and Other Strangers, The Baby Making, The Marriage of the Young Stockbroker, The Baby Move, The Little Lock, The Little Crook and the Nanny, Master of the Words, Talk to the Kids, Survivors, Companies, Had a Nice Day, Cut the Wrong Word, The Gravy Train, The Dion Brothers, Innocence, The Autobiography of Miss Jane Pittman, Punch and Jody, This By Saying, The Tech, Death, Be Not Proud, Live, Dudley, Bone, The Dawn of the Alexander, The Side of the Death, The Trial of Lee Hazard, Avril, Billy, Portrait of a Street Kid, The Hushers, Kid, The Man from Atlantis, The Man from Atlantis, Death's Cause, The Man from Atlantis, Killer Spores, The Man from Atlantis, Ivy. That only takes us up to 1974. This guy has been way too busy. We are very pleased to present the world premiere of Master Ching Hai's lyrical poetry put to music composed by Mr. Fred Carlin, who earlier I read his whole list of accomplishments was actually only up to the 70s, in a symphonic portrait of a journey in search of peace.
Yes, and it is called The Peace Seeker, conducted by Mr. Peter Bauer, with Miss Mel Kobik on vocals. And Mr. Carlin himself will be soloing on the trumpet and the flugelhorn. Ladies and gentlemen, The Peace Seeker.
Once upon a time, a true peace lover wandered around the many worlds in search of eternal happiness. She walked over the face of the earth, the suns, the moons, and the clouds. At last, she found that it was all the while buried in her very own heart. Then she sat down and was about to enjoy the newfound bliss, but suddenly, she looked down and saw countless beings were still groveling in darkness. For they were searching for happiness without, just like her before, erring over millions of ages. Her tears were then rolling down. One drop, two drops, and many more. Each drop became a shining jewel. And soon the firmament was studded with glittering tears, which are the stars today. They are too shy in the day and too restless in the night to go to sleep. For all peace seekers, the stars are there to light the way and to remind them of the compassion of a holy sage.
What can I do for my people? I love you, and ask not for myself, but for the sake of all beings under your will, may each one, in his place, find his peace.
Even worldly lovers would pity my heart, but you remain adamant. Worldly lovers can see each other whenever they wish. Only your door is forever forbidden. Every time I approach, it shuts, aloof and cold. The curtains are drawn. There is a dim light inside, but never once your face. I know you are in the palace. Just can't open the door. I think one day I'll bring along a big hammer. I know I'm far from being worthy, but I can assure you none is. So, loving Master, pray, do not tarry. Pull me out of the dark pit. Let me live in your light. Let me live in your boundless grace. Master, do you hear it all? You must, in order to hear my desperate call. I think I'll buy a pair of human ears for you tomorrow.
Daily, with every misfortune, everyone in a world full of misery. This expensive thing I possess that I can never sell nor throw away. This little heart of mine, so little and so fine, speeds enormously in the world full of misery.
Listen to music. My eyes adore beauty. My lips sing poetry. But my heart is full of melancholy. She cannot let me be free.
If there is reincarnation, I am going to be a flower, a fruit, a tree, or a plant. But never, never a human being again.
The world is a whirlpool full of scorpions and snakes, which bite with lust, anger, and hatred. And people are drowning helplessly therein. Oh, Master, King of all kings, please take them back to the mansion of peace and restore to them the eternal spring.
Won't someone tell me if you will ever return?
Oh Lord, I love you and ask not for myself, but for the sake of all beings in the world under your will, may each one find his peace.
Perhaps it was
The celestial granaries to scatter grains over the mountains, forests, to feed all the birds. When I see in wintry gust poor creatures on ragged wings looking for leftovers,
I want to bring nourishing food to the wild wandering felines living furtively in the ruined temples, weakened from the burning days and frozen nights.
I feel pity for the deer in the Rocky Mountains, wandering all day for a few dry leaves on steep hills as sad as old cemeteries. Where can they find sweet water and grass?
God's heart is forever desolate. Saving the world is a difficult mission. I kneel, wishing to believe in God and beg him to repair his creation.
When you cast your glance into the sea, O magnificent beloved, all the fish will become dragons, and they'll fly up to the clouds. Blessing rain will then start pouring down, fertilizing the field of human virtues and merits.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. All the wonderful performers in the Peace Seeker. That was magnificent. Much of what you are hearing this evening is poetry written by the Supreme Master, Ching Hai. Her poetry embodies the theme of one world of peace through music, with a rich background in a variety of artistic skills and a dedication to humanitarian activities for world peace. Supreme Master Ching Hai has committed her life to this ideal. Let's watch together a short video entitled Walk the Way of Love.
She has affectionately become known to those who've had the pleasure to meet or work with her, lives a message that walks the way of love. A renowned humanitarian, artist, and spiritual visionary, her love and assistance has extended beyond all cultural and racial boundaries to millions of people around the world, including the needy and homeless, institutions of medical research on AIDS and cancer, war veterans of the United States of America, the disadvantaged elderly, the physically and mentally handicapped, refugees, and victims of natural disasters such as earthquakes, floods, and fires.
It's a chaotic situation here.
The fire takes a toll at incredible speed.
These works, we witness countless reminders of compassion, which is the trademark of this caring lady, and the international foundation that has grown out of her loving example.
Whatever we can share, begin with sharing. And then we will feel a subtle change in ourselves. More love will be pouring into our consciousness, and we will be aware of something. And that is the beginning. We are here to learn to grow, as well as to learn to use our power, our limitless power of love and creativity, in order to make a better world wherever we happen to be.
Supreme Master Ching Hai was born in central Aulak. During her early years, she was often found helping hospital patients and the needy in whichever way she could. Above all, a burning spiritual quest since childhood led her to different paths of God's devotion. As a young adult, she moved to Europe to study and continued there as a volunteer nurse and translator for the Red Cross. She soon discovered that pain and suffering exist in all cultures and in all corners of the globe. And her search for the remedy for these ills became all the more the foremost goal in her life. She was happily married at the time to a German doctor, and although it was an extremely difficult decision for both of them, her husband agreed to a separation. She then embarked on a journey in search of spiritual understanding. Finally, in the deepest reaches of the Himalayas in India, she found an enlightened master who imparted to her the Kuan Yin method, a meditation technique which contemplates on the inner light and sound. After a period of practice, she became fully enlightened. Soon after her return from the Himalayas, at the earnest request of those around her, Master Ching Hai shared the Kuan Yin method with others, encouraging them to look within to find their own greatness. People from all walks of life found that through the Kuan Yin method of meditation, they attained greater fulfillment, happiness, and peace in their daily lives. Before long, invitations arrived from the United States, Europe, Asia, and South America, as well as the United Nations, for Master Ching Hai to give lectures.
The peace and love that we most often talk about and seek, we have within ourselves.
Mais le conséquent, c'est pas pareil. Es ist nur eine ununterbrochene Anstrengung.
The future is in our hands. So you make it beautiful or you make it worse, it's up to you.
As well as being a noble example of humanitarian aid, Master Ching Hai also encourages people to beautify the world we live in. Through meditating with the Kuan Yin method, Master Ching Hai has realized many spontaneous talents that she expresses through artistic paintings and creations, music and poetry, and aesthetic jewelry and dress designs, expressing the inner and outer beauty of the cultures and people she has met. In 1995, upon the demand of the public, her clothing creations were toured on the international fashion circuit, including London, Paris, Milan, and New York. The sales of all her artistic endeavors have enabled Master Ching Hai to create an independent source of funding for humanitarian activities, highlighting her pragmatic view that we should always try and create our own means from which to give others. Although she does not seek acknowledgement of any kind, in recognition of her selfless assistance, Supreme Master Ching Hai has been given awards worldwide by government officials and private organizations on numerous occasions, including the World Peace Award, the World Spiritual Leadership Award, Award for Promotion of Human Rights, the World Citizen Humanitarian Award, and the Award for Outstanding Public Service to Mankind.
She is the light of a great person, an angel of mercy for all of us.
Supreme Master Ching Hai is one of the truly dedicated people of this era, helping others find and create a beautiful vision of our future. Many great people in history have had a dream, and in her own words, so does Supreme Master Ching Hai.
I dream that all the world will become peaceful. I dream that all the killing will stop. I dream that all the children will walk in peace and harmony. I dream that all the nations shake hands with each other, protect each other, and help each other. I dream that our beautiful planet will not be destroyed. It takes billion trillions of years to produce this planet, and it's so beautiful, so wonderful. I dream that it will continue, but in peace, beauty, and love. Yeah, this is my dream.
That's a beautiful vision of peace, John.
You know, a vision of world peace begins with us and what we do with each moment. And speaking of moments, I'd like to move into a very important part of our program this evening. We have with us tonight representatives from two highly respected organizations that are well known for their commitment and leadership in serving our children. I would like to take this moment to invite Mr. Mark Cohen, president of the Starlight Children's Foundation, and Ms. Shoshana Grammer and Mike Drebe of St. Jude's Children's Research Hospital to please come up to the stage.
Thank you very much. I'm Mark, by the way, in case there's any confusion. We are delighted to be a part of the celebration on behalf of the Starlight Children's Foundation and part of One World Peace Through Music. The Starlight Foundation has spent the past 15 years dedicated to brightening the lives of seriously ill children all across the globe. We are gratified to be part of the Suma Ching Hai organization and your donation to us. Starlight Foundation helps on an annual basis over 500,000 seriously ill children. We work with over 57,000 children per month across the globe. We currently have 400 fund centers, which is a unit that is in hospitals all across the country that allows children who are in a hospital bed to be entertained by a VCR and Nintendo, and for those children that are unable to get out of their beds, it's wheeled from bed to bed. Additionally, we have Starlight Rooms here in Los Angeles, three different centers, one at Long Beach Miller Memorial, downtown at County USC, and at UCLA. Those rooms provide entertainment for the children, big screen televisions, computers, to teach the children and to have them learn and be educated, and also have a wonderful time, as wonderful as they can, while they're going through their particular illnesses, and hope to help them during that period of time. All of these and all of the volunteers of the Starlight Children's Foundation are delighted to be part of this wonderful celebration, and we are delighted to be here tonight. To Debbie, thank you so much, and to John, who is a board member of the Starlight Children's Foundation, we are delighted to be here, and we thank you for allowing us to be part of this wonderful evening.
Good evening. On behalf of the thousands of children across the world who tonight are fighting for their lives from cancer, AIDS, leukemia, and other catastrophic diseases, I thank you for opening up your hearts to the children from St. Jude Children's Research Hospital. The board of directors, volunteers, staff, doctors, and researchers are feverishly trying to find new cures for these diseases. And through the generosity shown to us this evening, we are closer to finding those cures. Our founder, entertainer, Danny Thomas, said, "No child should die in the dawn of his life." I believe that you all believe that with us too. And together tonight, we've come closer to realizing his dream. When the hospital and research center was opened in the early 1960s, there was only a 4% survival rate from these catastrophic diseases. But because of the research that's been done at St. Jude Children's Research Hospital, that survival rate is now 60%, and in some cases even 80 and 90%. And it's all through the generosity. Yeah, let's give it a hand. It's all done through the generosity of good people like you. So now when a mom and dad hears that their child has cancer or leukemia, it's not a death sentence. It means that there's hope, because 7 out of 10 children will survive that catastrophic disease. And we're very proud to report those research statistics. Danny Thomas also believed that children everywhere in the world should have the same opportunity for this kind of research and care. And just like you all are international, so is St. Jude. And children right now from 60 countries are being treated right now this year in Memphis, Tennessee. And we're reaching out without any kind of political or geographic boundaries to reach every child. Because right now, 1 out of 330 children will get cancer and leukemia, and we want that to be zero within our lifetime. The Suma Ching Hai International Association and St. Jude have something in common, and that's our love for children and our dedication to each other. Through this, we make miracles happen, and tonight you've made miracles happen for these children, and I thank you very, very much. Our past chair of our LA chapter, Mike Drebe, has a plaque of appreciation, and even though you all can't see that, I hope that you know that it comes from our hearts to you. Thank you very much.
Well, we've heard her name, her poetry, her vision, and some people got some plaques they want to give her. So isn't it time to meet the master herself? Please welcome Supreme Master Ching Hai.
Well, I can see her now. She's in white. She's coming right down the aisle. I can see it, and we're all excited. We are very excited.
There she is. And
here she comes.
Ladies and gentlemen, Master Ching Hai.
Hi, it's me. In the presence of my biggest idol, Miss Debbie, I am speechless. I watch all her movies, the old ones and the new one. Anyhow, I'm not going to take a lot of time from you. It was beautiful music, wasn't it? Yeah. I thank you so much for everything that you've done this evening for us and for God and for myself. It was really a nice surprise. I didn't think it was so big. I'm invited here for music and, you know, some composition of my poetry, but I did not imagine it's so grand an evening. I was so surprised and so delighted. So now come the most important part of our evening. I would like to represent all of you to offer a little contribution to these two great organizations who takes care of the children without condition, without wanting any reward. But God will know. God knows their effort. So this is from you to them. To sign it on your behalf. I told him.
Dear St. Jude Children's Research Hospital, in best wishes for the children, I would like to sincerely give a humble contribution of $150,000 to the St. Jude Children's Research Hospital. Thank you for your efforts in serving such a noble cause. Yours truly. Supreme Master, on behalf of the scientists, the doctors, the volunteers, and the staff at St. Jude's, but most especially the children, thank you so much for your generous support.
Thank God.
Thank you so much. Dear Starlight Children's Foundation, in best wishes for the children, I would sincerely give a humble contribution of $100,000 to the Starlight Children's Foundation. Thank you for your efforts in serving such a noble cause. And Supreme Master, on behalf of all of the children of the Starlight Children's Foundation, which number over 500,000, we thank you very, very much for your generous contribution.
Now, we don't want you to go anyplace because we have a surprise for you. Yes. And I'd like to ask Mr. Peter Boyer if he would come forward. He's somewhere hiding. He'll be right out. He's coming. We have a little surprise for you besides the lovely plaques that you received, but of course your gracious gifts were so generous. Everybody's very grateful. Oh, Peter Boyer, a little surprise.
Peter, how do you do?
So pleased to meet you.
Your music's wonderful.
Thank you. We have a little surprise for you.
More?
Even more. Surprise? Could it be? On behalf of the composers, Fred Collin and Maria Newman and myself, who have set your poetry for this concert, we want to thank you. And I was given a tape of a song for which you not only wrote music, but lyrics, but music as well, a song called Farewell Song.
Oh, I just hum along when I wrote. This and is a secret.
Not anymore, no.
You should not give it to people.
So the song for which you've composed lyrics and music, I have arranged this song for some members of our orchestra, and wonder if you might like to join us and sing. I think they want you to give it a shot.
You can do it. You go over there and she's going to sing. Ready? I thought it's a surprise for me, but this is not. What if I miss the tune and spoil his reputation? No, you won't do that.
What reputation?
Ready? I'll just jump in and sing Tammy if anything goes wrong.
Okay.
little musical conference.
I'm just trying to blackmail him to follow me. Oh, please have compassion. please help. Can I stand here?
Okay. You need your words? Do you need the words?
I might. I forgot everything already.
Yes. Here are your words.
Okay. Oh my goodness. Please forgive me if I miss a tune or two. I probably will miss a lot. See, we had a retreat for a few days now, and I've been talking every day to thousands of people. So I don't know if my voice will shock you out of your violin or not. Okay, please. I just try and you help to follow me. I cannot follow you. Okay. All right.
Well, where are you going? My winter sun, won't you miss me staying on this side of the sea? Where have you gone to, my tender moon? Oh, how I miss you. Stand on this side, water blue. I wish we could sail the same destination. I want to break these chains, oh my desperation. Hold you crying. When I see you, my only one, won't someone tell me if you ever return? I wish we could sail the same destination. I want to break these chains of my desperation. When I see you, my only one, won't someone tell me if you ever return? Where are you now, my only one? Won't someone tell me if you ever return? If you ever return. Thank you for being so kind.
That was wonderful. Supreme Master Ching Hai. Bravo! Bravo! Beautiful. That's really putting somebody on the spot. For a tiny girl, you certainly have a beautiful voice. What wonderful lyrics. I think this was very special tonight. Wasn't that wonderful and dear of her? I mean, I would have been scared to death. She did a beautiful job. I can't believe she did that. They told me, just tell her it'll be easy, but you know, that's very scary. I was very proud of her. Wasn't she wonderful? She sings beautifully. I had a figure like that when I was 14. We'll explain that later. 47, and don't forget. Over the years, we've all admired much of Hollywood's music. Certainly I have. From Gone with the Wind to Rocky. And Mr. Bill Conti composed many of these magical movie moments. For example, For Your Eyes Only, the theme from Rocky, and countless more. He's been the music director of the Academy Awards for the last 13 years. In fact, he's won the Academy Award and was honored with a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. Continuing tonight's theme, One World of Peace Through Music, I'm very pleased to introduce a true gentleman of the music world, Mr. Bill Conti.
Thank you very much. This first piece of music was from a movie that I did. And it was the piece of music that ended the movie. I begin with that, you see, because my career began at the end of that movie. I'd studied music all my life. I came from a musical family. My grandfather was a musician, my father a musician. I have two bachelor's degrees, a master's, and a doctorate in music. But my wife thought I majored in hunger and poverty until that Rocky movie came out. Yeah, I was nominated for an Academy Award and I lost, which is okay. I mean, it's not okay to lose all the time, but a young man didn't need an award. He needed what older men needed, money, a chance to further his career. So Rocky enabled me to do more films and more television. You see, because every time a piece of music is played on the air, the composer gets paid a little bit. My daughters are still in school. Anyway, I have some themes on the air now, but I've brought some of my favorites from the past, and maybe you'll recognize one or two. Thank you. That first piece was something that the ABC network used for the 84 and the 88 Olympics, followed by the theme from Falcon Crest and Lifestyles of the Poor and Hopeless, then the theme from Dynasty and Cagney and Lacey, of course. You know, a composer, many of us composers tonight are always asked the same questions. We get traditionally asked, what comes first, the words or the music? Well, the truth is, first comes the phone call. The next question that we're asked is, what motivates you? What inspires you? What about receiving notification in the mail that your wife has been inducted into the Master Charge Hall of Fame? So we're motivated by the same reasons that everyone is, fear and desire. But I did get a phone call, which is a part of our life, which should be immediately followed by a lunch. My agent got a phone call from the producer of the James Bond movies and said he'd like to have lunch with me in a couple of days. Called me and I says, oh, that'd be great. Now, lunch doesn't mean you're doing the movie, that just means you're having lunch, right? So this is on a Tuesday, and I call the agent and says, well, where would he like to have lunch? I'm thinking any of these places around town where you don't really eat, you kind of talk, you shake hands, stuff like that. Anyway, he says, well, this is Tuesday. He'd like to have lunch with you on Thursday, but he's in London. Ah, that's okay. So what happens is the limousine comes to your door because you have to travel by limousine. Picks you up, takes me to LAX. You travel first class because it's got to be first class. 12 hours to London, picked up by a limousine, and taken to your suite because you must have a suite. In my case, it was at the Dorchester Hotel where you freshen up, come down, and had lunch with the producer. Now, we talked about the weather, we talked about the flight, we talked about 100 things, including the movie. After lunch, back in the limo, Heathrow, 13 hours back, limo picks you up and takes you home. Now, we had lunch. Okay, now the point of this is, the next time you read in the newspaper, this movie cost $90 million. This movie cost $100 million. You got to know that little skinny guys like me are flying all over the world just having lunch. It's true. I ended up doing the movie. The name of the movie was For Your Eyes Only. The song was For Your Eyes Aunt, Your Eyes Only. Sheena Easton sang the song for me. I was nominated for an Academy Award, and I lost.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. I have had the opportunity to conduct the Academy Awards show a few times. And you know, it's a live show. And you know that things can go wrong during a live show. They do go wrong. And do you get the feeling I'm going to tell you about a couple? I have had an opportunity to work with everyone from Barbra Streisand to Willie Nelson to Placido Domingo. So many people have come through that show, and the very, well, I want to tell you about a little girl by the name of Madonna. Very interesting, very talented lady. When she was nominated, the song from Dick Tracy, Stephen Sondheim's song Sooner or Later, it was called, was nominated. I, as the musical director, get to call the artist to see if they would like to perform on the show. The Sooner or Later was a very pretty ballad, a very beautiful tune. I called Madonna and I says, we'd like you to sing on the show. Would you like to do it? She says, I'd like to do it, you know, I'd like to do it differently. I'd like to do it like a striptease. I was shocked. So, okay, we worked on an arrangement that seemed to be like a stripper-type number, a little rowdy. And we worked on it for a month because she practices very hard, really worked on the arrangement, every move, every nuance of the song she studied. So, we performed it right here on this stage, right? We're in the pit here, and the number kind of, she came out of an elevator in the back. In other words, the band went da-da-da-da-da, like a big striptease number. She came up out of the elevator, struck an attitude, stopped, the music began again, and she slinked forward, really slinky. And a microphone came out of the stage, then she began to sing. Okay, to sing. So, during the rehearsal that we have here, this is the way the rehearsal went. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. She comes out of the elevator, she strikes this attitude, and she comes out of her dress. You can't do that. You can't do that. No, the producer says, no, you can't do that. You have to change the dress. This was very, very disturbing for her, but she changed the dress. All right, da-da-da-da-da-da-da. She comes out of the elevator, she takes the attitude, stays in her dress. Music began again, da-da-da-da, and she's slinking forward. And the microphone comes up out of this stage like this. Well, if you're sexy and you're trying to slink, you can't do this. Okay, so we say, sweetheart, nothing can go wrong the night of the show, which is in a matter of 2 hours. So during the show, I'm down here, and it's time for the Madonna number. We're going, da 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 da, and over the headphones I hear, Madonna's stuck in the elevator. You're bored, I understand it. It's a very boring show, I understand. You're bored, we're having heart attacks. So these big beefy guys come and they push her up on stage. She comes up, deer in the headlights. She's like that, she is freaked out. The music continues to play, now she's slinking forward, right? Da, 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 da. But the microphone's not coming up. So she's slinking slowly. She's looking at me, I'm looking at her anyway. In the end, someone brought her a microphone and she sang. She didn't like it, but she sang. And it was all because someone forgot to push the button that made the microphone come up. This next piece I prepared for the Academy Award show, this is not a contest, but there are 28 Academy Award winning tunes in this medley. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Okay, we'll play it again. No. I'm only kidding. The orchestra just passed out when you said that. You know, I mentioned I've lost. I've mentioned that. Well, you know, it's easy to win, but it's unique to lose while you're conducting the orchestra. You know, we kind of watch each other. We have eye contact. We're kind of looking at each other. And you know, we don't know who the winners will be, right? So there are maybe 30-something categories and 5 nominees in each category. So all the musicians and myself have 5 different pieces of music. So when they say the winner is, we have to find the right piece of music and play it, because that piece of music is connected with that particular picture. At the top of the piece of music is the name of, let's say, a costume design, Out of Africa, Jenny Smith, JS, if she has a nickname. Her girlfriend opens it up and says, oh, it's Jenny. Well, we have all that information. If they win and they say something, we can identify it and play the right person. But when you're nominated and you're conducting, you don't have time to get nervous. But when you get right down to that moment, and you see your name among all the others, and you look in the eyes of the musicians, and in their eyes they say, oh, I hope you win, I hope you win, I hope I work with you next week, I hope you win. No, I think they want me to win, I believe that. I do, I believe that. So they call it out, and it's someone else, you don't win. What happens? The musician's eyes look down, they don't want to meet, oh my God, he lost. The director's going, music, music. I said, I can't, nobody's looking at me. I did win once. The name of the movie was The Right Stuff. So this is the music from The Right Stuff. You know, the first time that I did that Academy Award show was in 1977, and he's the guy down the bottom of your little picture screen wearing the headphones and the baton. But what you don't know about the headphone is that there's someone in this ear screaming and yelling. And there's someone else in this ear screaming and yelling. There's a script for the show. There's the music. There's a forest has been destroyed to create the music. There's a lot of music. There's over 3 hours of music. I have a microphone, because when the director talks to me, I have to talk and answer him back. But I don't need an open microphone like this. I need a microphone with a switch. So my hands are kind of busy. So I have a foot switch. So the director says, we're not doing this now, we're doing that. And I say, okay. Now I have to tell the musicians. They're all wearing one earphone, just so that I can tell them. But I need another switch to talk to them. That's over here. Now, if I have something wrong with the two monitors that I have to talk to engineering. Yes, there's another switch. So the first time I did it, you can imagine I might be a little nervous. People like Henry Mancini, Elmer Bernstein had done the movie, had done that show so many times, and you can't prepare for it. I was nervous. Sure, I was nervous. I had a headache that Demerol would not take away, let alone Bayer aspirin. My head was exploding. It's time to go on the air, and we hear in this earphone, we go on in 30 seconds, in 29, in this ear it's going, in 19, in 18. It's a time delay thing. Don't listen to that one, listen to the left ear. So we play along, and then the winner is, there's 5 different pieces of music. And you play the right one, and then someone wants to thank their other third grade teacher, and you don't play the music. So during all of this, one of the musicians grabs my leg, and I jump about a mile. I uncover an earphone, and I say, well, what's the matter? He says, we smell smoke. We're in a pit like this, but way down, right? There's only one entrance. So I hit my switch to the director, and I say, some of the musicians smell smoke. Oh my goodness, he's screaming and yelling. Well, it's genetic with me. I'm screaming and yelling back, and I'm listening. We're not going to die for this show. Do something. So on their hands and knees, with their helmets and their hatchets, come the firemen. Can you imagine them crawling among the ladies and gentlemen of the orchestra while the show was going on and you're bored? So what had happened was the night before, they had painted the lights on the music stands, and they were smoldering. This last song was nominated, but it lost. But it brought in a lot of money. thank you so much. And we have people to thank, but I need a piano to do it. There wouldn't be a piano here, would there? I meant a green piano. Thank you. Yes, I've enjoyed your enthusiasm all night for music. Music is so special. I know you like music. I know you love music. I'd like you to remember something, though. If music has ever meant something in your historical past, if it's ever brought back a memory, you know, if it's ever excited you or made you happy or any of those things that music can do, what I do as a composer and all the other gentlemen and ladies as composers have done and is all alone in a room. What we do is inside our heads. We convert our emotions to music. And in that human way, that if I'm doing a love scene and I know what I feel like when I'm in love, I hope that you will get that message because you will feel the same love, this humanness that we share. But we write little lifeless notes. Don't ever forget, please don't ever forget, that if music has made you laugh, if music has made you cry, it's because the ladies and gentlemen of the orchestra have put all the passion and soul into lifeless notes. These are wonderful musicians. I actually love them. We do have someone else to thank, and we'd like to do it like musicians do, through music. And it is actually for the person who has inspired the evening. The inspiration, someone had to think of it for us to do it. Someone had to have those thoughts. And we simply would like to say, thank you. A piece of music that you have written, words and music, that we would like to perform for you.
Oh, So far, we have been on a journey into a number of styles of music, and our next act is certainly no stranger to the stage. Originating in the 1960s, the Beach Boys' sounds and style were formative to American music. Over the years, many of their hits have become household names. I couldn't even list all of them in a minute. They are just incredible, and they are riding the next wave in the great tradition of the Beach Boys. We are proud to bring to you tonight Beach Boys Family and Friends, bringing together the talents of Al Jardine and his two sons, Matt and Adam, with the Wilson sisters from Wilson Phillips, Fame, Wendy, and Carney Wilson, and a host of friends who've played or been affiliated with the original Beach Boys over the years. I'm excited to introduce to you tonight, they are launching the start of their national tour. Ladies and gentlemen, Beach Boys Family and Friends.
We are about to do this.
Yeah.
You're a rocker.
Get up and clap.
Since you put me down, I've been out doing in my head. Come in late at night, then in the morning.
Thank you so very much. I'd like to dedicate, actually we'd like to do a dedication right now, this kind of, impromptu, to the Supreme Master, Ching Hai. We'd like to dedicate this next song, it's called God Only Knows.
As there are stars above you, you'll never
believe me, the world could show nothing to me. So what good would living do me? Good God only knows what I'd be without you.
Debbie, I got to tell you, it was great sharing the stage with you. It was like you're one of my idols, and you were just wonderful to work with.
Oh, you were wonderful, and you guys are great. We enjoyed it so much.
Just terrific. Why don't we call all of the performers back out on stage now for final bow after this great night?
The best performers are all these people out here. You all have been wonderful. I tell you, you've been a great audience for all of us. We thank you very much.
All right.
Here comes everybody. Bill Conti, Peter Boyer, George Thacher, Gaelic Storm, Fred Carlin, Anne-Marie Ketchum, Catherine Hudson, Carrie Walsh. Big round of applause. Now, of course, this evening would not be possible without one person, and we would like to invite our special guest of honor up to the stage at this time. Please welcome back to the stage Supreme Master Ching Hai.
Stop the embarrassing voice.
I was not prepared to sing that song tonight, so it was very embarrassing. especially in front of all the professionals and the most famous people here. But it's okay, it's for fun. It's Christmas. And you are very charitable. Well, it was more than wonderful. I didn't expect to have such a beautiful evening. I'm so thrilled. It was a great honor. And I don't know if I deserve it, but God is merciful. And we have all these great people here with us in the flesh. You know, we have their CDs, their video, or their film, but to meet them in person is something really very, very honorable, very special. And not every of us can meet them more than once in a lifetime, not even once in a lifetime. So please honor them again. Thank you so much. Please come to the front. No, people cannot see you. People cannot see you. Come to the front, please. Come to the front. Come to the front so people can see you. Can you see them, all of them? Mr. Bill Conti. don't hide behind there, both of you. Don't hide. Come on. You're the great people. I never dreamed I could meet you.
My pleasure.
My God. And I know your song too. Can you sing that?
But you sang with him.
No, but...
I was waiting.
Can you hum it now?
Me, I can't hum. No.
The favorite one that you just sang. Can you introduce again that? You sang again that favorite song?
A favorite, what?
The one that make him famous.
I'm 47, I can't remember anything.
try.
The theme from Rocky? You're the master supreme, you say. You, what? She's putting me on the spot just because I asked you to sing. Now you want me to introduce a song that I don't remember.
Never mind, I'm not talented, so just leave it. If I sing his song, maybe he will go down in the history. All right, we thank them again and again and again for making this evening possible and for the benefit of all the children. We thank you again and again very much. Yes. And may God bless you 1,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000, And thank you. You have been a very wonderful audience. Very quiet. And for you, that's for you. I don't deserve flowers. I am a flower. If you're not careful, I might fall in love with these people because I love music. And when I see a musician in the flesh, I feel kind of, you know, trembling in my heart. Since I was young, I'm always fond of these things like music, movie stars, you know, all those goodies stuff. But I have never dreamed that I have an honor to meet you people. It's incredible. If God has not blessed me so much, I would not have this opportunity. Many people want to meet you so much, they could never, they can just watch on the screen. I'm so thrilled. Are you not very thrilled too? Yeah. Here you are.
How about one big round of applause for the star of the evening, really? Thank you very much.
love.